Lucifer and the evil angels were cast out of heaven. But Lucifer received an even greater punishment. He, once the most beautiful of the angels, was transformed into the hideous Satan.
Ain't it sad when a story or a chapter in a book comes to an end, or a movie comes to a close, or when a series ends? That's what's happening here. IW Throwdown is coming to a close. But before we move on to the new era of what's to come to for us here in Throwdown, we all have some unfinished business. The house has some unfinished business to attend to. Especially me, the bad child, has a little something to attend to. Mr. Phenom. As I said earlier, I could have sworn someone retired you long ago. Unless my memory serves me wrong, which it usually doesn't. But, to say the least, you should have just stayed in your retirement home, living it up in whatever you do in retirement. But you didn't. You decided that you would come back here and step foot in a throwdown ring and take me on. Take the bad child on. I might have lost to Nick White, but that doesn't matter, because this week we will make our final statement here in IW Throwdown and make it officially done and make the ending of Throwdown something to remember, something that the people will remember, even though it doesn't matter what they really think. We want to make a lasting impression. When you look back at Throwdown, what do you want to see? Do you want to see, you want to remember the ending? Or what happened leading up to the ending? You don't want to think about what happened when it closed, when we closed. You want to think about the show that sent it off and how Asakura eliminated the modern day Phenom from existence and retired him at that. Because honestly, all that matters to you is eliminating people and getting paid and continuing your legacy as a Phenom. But I don't really see it. I just see you as an old man who should be just resting and relaxing and waiting for his day. His time in the limelight is over. Your time in the limelight has come and gone. It's my time to shine. It's the House of Rage's time to shine. And we will rise. And we will grow stronger. I don't really need to focus my energy on you, because if you look elsewhere in the territories, I'm dealing with Ivy League and Brother Moses. I got my fucking hands full. So try again, and next time stay fucking retired for once, for real. I don't think anyone wants to see an old man face on that screen anymore and really care what you have to say, because all it is talk. and talk, as they say, is cheap. And honestly, I get sick and tired of hearing the same shit come out of people's mouths when it comes to the House of Rage. That we don't have anything. That, or as Moses says, the House of Blades, or whatever the fuck else we got called in the past. It don't matter. It really doesn't matter. It just sickens me. So in all, let me finish off with this. The house always wins.